light's always been really important to me. I lost my sight when I was younger, and I lived in a world of darkness from an eye injury. And you know, when you are totally blind for 4 months, in the minute they unveil and you can see and let light in,
right.
It became an element that I could only exist in, and hence the way my world has played out. You know, I just feel really lucky that I've been able to do what I love to do, and people pay me to do it too. And I get to work with the best directors, the best production designers, cinematographers, and the last 10 years now I've been showing my work at museums and art shows and meeting all sorts of amazing artists, and I'm having a good time. So I'm gonna just kind of show you a lot of the visuals that I create. Most of it is all background, but with the use of neon lighting, you really get a sense of, it could give you a time period if we're trying to go back in time or we're trying to go forward in time. It establishes where you are at the moment. And, So I'm just gonna show you a little bit, and if you guys wanna stop, you know, I can stop and talk because I don't wanna bore you with a lot of visuals. But the one thing I do wanna point out is it's stuff that you really don't notice when you're probably watching television and film, but if it wasn't there, you would really know that something was missing. So it's background, but background is really critical to making a scene happen and make people feel like they're inside there. So let's see if I can figure this guy out. This movie, I did not do, but it inspired me so much, and I dreamed of being able to do things like this. So Blade Runner, I'm sure you are all, this movie can stand it. You know, you can watch this movie today. It's still as much as it was before. So again, I created a world on, I worked on several Batman movies, and I had to go back quite a bit. I've been doing this for 3 decades, so I had to have a lot of stuff transferred from VHS, and some of this I'm seeing for the first time.
Batman.
Wait a minute, that's not Batman.
What are you talking about?
That's Batboy.
You ain't the Bat.
So again, you can see what lighting, if you didn't have that background lighting in that scene, the entire scene would be completely flat. This is the Batmobile, and this was all done with neon lighting. It was done at a time where LED lighting wasn't really up to par. So this entire car, it was a great project for me because this car really had to drive, and it had to go about 150 miles an hour and get the brakes slammed on, and you know, it worked. Very proud of working on this vehicle. This is the set. This is how it looks. You can see how flat it is without all the rest of the stuff that comes into play. This is the neon that was inside the Batmobile, just underneath every bit of that car. Another Steven Spielberg film I worked on. And again, lots of background lights and neon. A Target commercial I did with Gwen Stefani. again, a lot of neon lighting. Most of the work that I do is dimensional, and that is one of the most difficult things to do because you're not really working from a pattern that's flat on the table. So it's an interpretation. I'll do it out of wire. I've done structures out of yarn, you know, to try to get the team on board with where I'm going with this project, because it's all of us that are going to put our creativity in there. You know, I'm sort of the one who comes up with it, and I oversee every little bit of it, but yeah, and it is super fragile. It's like a light bulb. So I have to be concerned with my sculptures getting to the show, and I'm like a cat on a hot tin roof until, you know, I'm texting Stephen Lana every day, did my sculptures make it? Did you take them out of the crate? Did you plug it in, you know? And then I have to have support team. There's somebody here from your own town that has helped me last year when we had a mishap and a lot of glass got broken right before the show. And I have to rely on a lot of people all over, wherever my work goes. If I do a movie in New York, I have to rely on a company there to back me up in case, you know, everything breaks right before showtime. It's a creative process. And there's a lot of times where we don't really get a lot of time, especially in film and television and music videos. Somebody may come to me, you know, 3 days before, you know, they're going to start shooting on a little napkin, you know, and they want this to be 40 to 50 feet long and tall, and, you know, how much money is it going to cost? So, you know, I need to have people that can jump on the computer really quick and start drawing this out and figuring out how much money this is, you know. In the good old days, they didn't care. The first question they asked was, can you do this in our time frame? But now times have changed and people do ask how much money it is. And again, it requires, I have amazing people, and I really push them and work them so hard sometimes. But, you know, I mean, we get to see our work on, you know, television and film. I mean, it's also very rewarding to do that. I am really used to working under pressure and deadlines and, you know, having a target date for something to be completed by. I get really excited when I get a show and I have to create a new body of work, and I have 6 months. So there is an end to sight, because I could, you know, keep going back in and tearing it apart and redoing it. Sometimes having too much time on my hands, I think for me, I struggle with that because I'm not used to it. This was a very early one I did. And again, these are just, 20-foot curved walls of chasing neon. For about 5 years, and I had literally been collecting dried driftwood that had just washed up on the shore, and I really never knew what I was going to do with it, but I was relating to that wood because of the beauty of it just in its natural form. So I started to take a few pieces and, you know, stare at it for a long time, because there's such beauty in that wood that it's got to speak to you, it's got to tell you what it needs to have. And so in that has opened up my own exploration of having to look deeper inside of myself and reflect. And that whole series has been, I think, a turning point for me and a spiritual journey. And I, you know, but sometimes I've just got to pop out of it and, you know, create 14-foot sculptures and, you know, I will always work with natural organic forms, because neon is one of the most natural organic forms there are. I mean, it could last 100 years. And, you know, I really want people to notice neon in a fine art way, because neon is always considered just signage in the background. And, you know, I think if, before I leave this planet, if I could just share a different take on what neon, and I know for me, because I've been doing so much film and television work, I just really want to share the beauty and the sex. You can make it beautiful, you can make it sexy, you can make it loud, and I think it just reflects where I am. Working with the people I worked with, I would have to say at the beginning, I was very stressed out because I was, as they say, a gun for hire, okay? So I better deliver, and I better deliver on time. So there was that going on. But I mean, as the company developed and people started to see my creativity, they came to me because of, I'm the neon queen, is what they call me, you know, and there's a reason for it, you know. I was hired to create a three-dimensional sculpture of a car. It doesn't look anything like that. That's the finished product. I used organic leaves and three-dimensional neon, and this is my take on what their car feels like to me. You know, I have to feel that the image of theirs will relate to my language before I even take it on. So that's a factor for sure. If it's not going to read, I'm not going to do it. And I know that. And sometimes people don't want to hear that. But, you know, I can already see the piece done before it's done. So some of my influences, I'm sure you all know them. They opened the door up for me to really think and believe I can continue to do my neon as an art form. Tracy Emmons, I think she really turned the page for a lot of people that are doing neon now. So I don't want to take too much time because I think my time is up here. Thank you, guys.